Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno welcomes the swift creation of a panel dedicated for military and uniformed personnel pension reforms. On Wednesday, the House of Representatives created an ad hoc committee that will craft a new pension system for MUP retirees. This after several government officials pushed for a more sustainable fiscal framework for the pension system. It will be led by Albay Representative Joey Salceda, who said the committee will come up with their proposals before the 2024 national budget deliberations later this month. Philippine Senator Coco Pimentel hits the Marcos administration's proposed 5.7 trillion pesos 2024 national budget. He says the allocation of over 9 billion pesos for confidential intelligence funds raises serious questions about government's priorities. He called that budgetary decision a huge mistake. The Senate minority leader vowed to scrutinize the proposed budget. The Philippine Commission on Audit flags state health insurer PhilHealth for spending over 8 billion pesos on RT-PCR tests. This was spent from April 2020 to May 2022. According to the COA, payment to the private contractor for 2.48 million tests was made despite incomplete case investigation forms or CIFs. The CIFs are needed to prove that the tests were conducted. Meanwhile, PhilHealth stresses that its partnership took place in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic when urgency in immediate care and specimen testing was necessary. The Philippines and the U.S. are set to hold joint patrols in the West Philippine Sea. This was revealed by Jonathan Malaya, the Assistant Director General for the Philippine National Security Council. Malaya says a key strategy of Manila in the West Philippine Sea is strengthening partnerships with allies while supporting a rules-based international order. Malaya says the joint patrols may start before the end of the year, but he clarifies details are still being ironed out.
Paliwanag naman under international law kung ano yung international seas, no? Basta tayo, we adhere with the UNCLOS. Kung ano man nakalagay sa UNCLOS, no? Where international law allows us to sail, doon tayo magsisail.
When asked about the prospect of having a joint military exercise with China, Malaya said there is no legal basis at the moment. He also said they have not received such a proposal from Beijing. Senator J.V. Ejercito pushing to include lessons about the West Philippine Sea in the school curriculum. He says this move is essential for the next generation to continue the fight for the country's territory.
It's not necessary anymore to make another subject. Isama na sa social sciences yan or even history na talagang so that our youth, our students would know that disputed area, that West Philippine Sea is ours based on the Hague ruling. Dapat nang incorporate na rin po yun so that they would know in the future generations na talagang atin po yan. No? Malinaw na maliwanag na maliwanag.
Senator Risa Hontiveros earlier put this plan forward, particularly in basic and higher education. The Education Department, for its part, says they have not reached a final decision on the issue. Please be kind to my country. This remark coming from former President Rodrigo Duterte's recent meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping. Senator J.V. Ejercito says it was President Marcos who relayed Duterte's encounters after his visit to Malacañang on Wednesday. Duterte met with a Chinese leader in Beijing 2 weeks ago in a bid to continue promoting friendly cooperation between the two countries. In other news, search teams have found the wreckage of a Cessna plane that went missing several days ago in the northern Philippines. The plane was found in the town of Luna in Apayao Province, around 50 kilometers from its intended destination at the Tuguegarao Airport. Authorities have recovered the bodies of the pilot and his pilot trainee. The cause of the crash is still being investigated. It is the third aviation incident in the Philippines this year involving a Cessna aircraft. Flooding in the North Luzon Expressway could persist until early next week. That's according to the NLEX Traffic Management. Days of heavy rains caused the Pampanga River to swell, inundating parts of the expressway, particularly in San Simon area. The floods resulted in slow-moving traffic. The southbound lane is the most affected, with the traffic buildup stretching 9 kilometers. The NLEX Traffic Management vowed to ramp up efforts to fix the flooding issue.
Sa loob ng expressway, sino-fortify po namin yung mga sandbagging namin magkabilang side ng San Simon sa Bintulao area. Tapos marami kaming pumps na ginagamit. Sinasiphon po namin yung tubig, then dinadump po away from the area. At meron din po mga tuloy-tuloy na pumps. Actually, nag-source out pa po kami ng mas maraming pumps. para lalo pa pong mapababa yung level ng tubig. So yung tiningnan na po namin, pagka mga matataas na sasakyan, class 2 and 3, pwede na po actually silang mag-reroute from Pulilan, then MacArthur, then re-entry na lang po sila ng San Fernando. Kasi pag San Simon po, medyo malalim po yung bahay.
Over now to Metro Manila's main thoroughfare, which is undergoing a one-time big-time repair after days of heavy downpour further damaged the highway. Our correspondent Jose Carretero joins us with the latest from EDSA. Jose, good afternoon. What's the latest up there?
Good afternoon, Rica. The road repairs and asphalt overlay along the EDSA bus carousel lanes are now ongoing. The repair, according to Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, started 10 Friday night. With the ongoing repairs, MMDA said traffic along EDSA will be affected, especially in some portions of Quezon City and Mandaluyong. But according to Quezon City Traffic and Transport Management Department, traffic along EDSA, including Mabuhay Lanes, is still manageable since this morning. According to Dexter Cardenas, the head of QC Traffic and Transport Management Department, no traffic buildup was observed even in intersections. Additional traffic enforcers have been deployed in Quezon City to manage traffic, especially during mall hours where congestion is expected. Meanwhile, some EDSA carousel bus drivers said they have already experienced slight delay in their regular trips due to the ongoing road works. Some say an additional one-hour delay has been noted. The MMDA said a stop-and-go scheme is being implemented in areas where asphalt overlay is being done. This means the carousel bus will use the second lane of EDSA, in turn affecting private vehicles. MMDA are advising motorists to avoid EDSA. Signages were installed in some parts of Mabuhay Lanes and EDSA to warn motorists of the ongoing road repairs. Motorists can take Mabuhay Lanes, and those coming from the south and north areas may use the Skyway.
Tayo naman po ay nakipagpulong sa DPWH, sa kanilang contractor, ganoon din po sa mga traffic unit ng mga lokal na pamahalaan para po pagpreparahan nga ito at gawa ng magandang traffic management plan. As we speak, although nagkakaroon ng build-up or queuing doon sa mga areas kung saan may ginagawa, manageable naman pa po yung traffic.
Meanwhile, Rica, commuters can use MRT3 as an alternative mode of transportation while the road repairs are ongoing. MMDA advised motorists to check their social media accounts for the alternate routes to avoid congestions. The road repairs will last until 5 a.m. Wednesday, August 9. Rica.
Thank you so much, Jose Carretero, reporting live. The Philippine Environment Department hints at possibly halting reclamation projects in Manila Bay. That's after the U.S. Embassy in Manila warned of the negative environmental impact of one of the projects. Vivian Gulia reports.
The Department of Environment and Natural Resources urges caution on land reclamation projects in Manila Bay. Environment Secretary Maria Antonia Yulo Loizaga has floated the idea of temporarily stopping reclamation activities until they complete their cumulative impact assessment.
But this process can take some time. So what we are saying here is that the concern really would be to see whether we could maybe halt, minimize activities muna hanggang matapos itong cumulative impact assessment.
Until we can get a very good sense of what scientifically is going to happen in this area, and until we can get a very good sense of how the rule of law can be followed in this area, okay, we want to proceed with much caution.
The environment chief added that the new reclamation activities at the Manila Bay will hinder government's compliance to a Supreme Court mandamus that ordered agencies to clean up, rehabilitate, and preserve Manila Bay, as well as restore and maintain its waters to be fit for swimming and other forms of recreation.
Our job is, sa DNR, is to say, sandali lang po, nagko-comply ba ito? O ecologically sound pa ba ito? And there are laws in place, no? And plus the mandamus order, which we need to implement. So ayan po yung challenge namin ngayon.
Senate Committee on Environment and Natural Resources Chairperson Senator Cynthia Villar backs the conduct of an environmental impact study on the reclamation activities at Manila Bay.
Give a chance to Secretary Loizaga to study para may power naman kayo to change yung ECC. Oh, kung makikita na environmentally not correct yung binigyan ng ECC.
The U.S. Embassy previously expressed concern over the potential negative and irreversible impacts to the environment of the reclamation projects in Manila Bay. It is also concerned with the involvement of China Communications Construction Company, citing its role in helping the Chinese military construct artificial islands in the South China Sea. One of the reclamation projects is being done by the Waterfront Manila Premier Development Incorporated. In an interview with Teleradio Serbisyo, its chairman, Sergio Ortiz Luis Jr., asserts they underwent the regulatory processes, including consultations with concerned parties. He adds the U.S. Embassy was also invited, but it did not participate.
Maraming consultation magmula noong 2016. Lagi may imbitasyon ng a U.S. Embassy. They never attended. I know that for a fact. It's not fair. Now, after all this process, bigla na lang pumasok itong kumpanya involved sa South China Sea, whatever.
Opo.
Check.
Opo.
Hindi naman blacklisted sa World Bank. Na kaming nalig na kung bakit bigla na lang binablacklist yung isang kumpanya.
Former Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio says a Chinese firm involved in the formation of artificial islands in the South China Sea should not be allowed to take part in reclamation projects in Manila Bay.
We should come to our senses. Itong company na ito, whether it's China Communication Construction or a subsidiary, the same owner yan eh, papayagan ba natin yan na hinuka yung mga atoll reefs natin sa Spratly para to create those artificial islands na naval and air basis na ngayon ng China para i-enforce yung 9-dash line laban sa atin, no?
Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.